Hey, horse people. Got this email, and I keep telling people don't send me emails, but I have like 1,400 emails now that I haven't read. So if you sent me an email, when I open my email on my phone, when I'm either out or stuck in traffic or sitting somewhere waiting for something, I'll try to hit a couple emails. It puts the most current at the top, and I just happen to read it. But, you know, there's 8 or 10 other below that keeps getting pushed down. And like I said, I've still got emails from December that I haven't read. So I try to work my way through them. This one happened to pop up. I read it, so I'm going to do a little video on it. Okay. I'm a fan of yours, been watching you for years. You know, I always say they always kiss you before they screw you. so they're always nice right before they ask. Anyway, so she says she's in the process of putting in a video critiquing my horsemanship. And she has this little Arabian filly, which is really cute. And let's see, there's no glaring issues. She likes to turn her butt. I've nipped the kicking issue, but mostly while out of range. Can you take a look? I don't expect her to be perfect, although Mr. T is. Mr. T ain't perfect. He thinks he is. Buddy thinks he is. I don't think he is. He's pretty good horse, though. Anyway, I digress. So let's take a look at this video. Okay, so, and again, I'm looking at this video from seeing only what she's videotaping. So when I critique a video like this, I just kind of notice things that kind of pop out. And it may mean nothing, and it's not personal, and I'm not saying this woman is bad and mean and all. These are just how I view things and what I see. So I see a nice trailer. I see a nice barn. I see good fencing. So I see sand, a nice groomed arena. So I see a lot of things that while I'm watching this horse do this, and I'm just going to comment on things I see. Oh, let me stop the music. She put nice music in here. All right. So first thing I see when I saw this is I'm like, why are you in the corner? You don't want to be in a corner of an arena where you're trapped so the horse can come in and then it can kick you and it can determine where you're at. Now, a lot of people will feel safe in a corner of arena because they're like, now the horse can't get behind me. Now I don't have to spin. And now I know the horse, I've cut down to where the horse can only approach me in this 90-degree angle of area. So it's easier to defend myself if I'm in a corner. I don't disagree with that. Plus, I think it shows that you're scared of the horse and you're not confident that you can keep the horse off you. I'm not saying she's that way. I don't know if she got trapped or if that's where she started videotaping. I'm just saying she's videotaping from a corner. When I saw this, what was running through my mind is I don't like trapping myself in a corner. I want to be out in the open so the horse has plenty of room to react to me, and I have plenty of room to react to the horse, because either one of us may have to move because the other one isn't paying attention. So I like being in the middle and in the open, but I'm confident that I can keep a horse off me, and I don't need to limit my area. Another thing I see is when you're filming, can't step in the same river twice. You can't film and train at the same time because you change what you're saying. I always get confusing things from Buddy and Mr. T when I'm holding a camera because it's very difficult. And even if I'm not holding a camera, when I'm talking to the camera, when I'm focusing on what I want to say and what I want the message to be and what I'm trying to communicate, that is distracting me from paying attention to the horse and communicating with the horse with my nonverbals in my body. So if she thinks that she's training, and I don't know if she is, if she thinks she's lunging or training this horse while videotaping, she's not doing it right. She's not being fair to the horse. She's ripping the horse off, and she's ripping herself off because she's not giving the horse 100% when she's with the horse. And she's not paying attention to little things that she should be paying attention to because she's holding the camera, trying to keep it in focus, trying to spin, trying to keep the horse off her, trying to maneuver, trying to give the horse good communication with the rope while I'm holding the camera in one hand, holding the rope in the other hand, and all, trying to keep the horse in center and enjoying the beauty of my horse running. And you've got all these things going on, and it just it distracts you from focusing. That's why I always say good horse people keep their mouth shut. If you're talking while you're working with a horse, then you're not concentrating on the body. You're not using the body. You're going to use words as a cheat to sometime say, you know, don't come in here, baby. Oh, yeah, that's a good baby. Oh, yeah. And when you're talking, you're neglecting focusing on your body and what message you're sending with the body. Horses are all about body language. They really don't care about the wah, 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 wah. All right, let's go. Okay, so she has a rope in her hand, and she's swinging the rope, and she's holding the camera, and she's trying to keep the horse in. And the horse is playing, and it ran in on her, and it wants to come to her. So another thing in a minute, you're going to see this horse run to this corner of the arena. To me, this horse has a draw to this corner. Why does it have a draw? People create draws, and they don't understand, and that affects training. If you always walk your horse in and out of one gate in one arena, your horse is always going to know that this is how I get out of here. This is how I don't have to train. And he's always going to have a draw to the gate. Now, I don't know if there's a gate in this arena or this is why the horse is here. I see the horse trailer here. I see the edge of the barn. Maybe this is where stupid humans come out of the barn and give the horse treats. Maybe this is when the horse is locked up in this area with no grass and he's only got sand. Maybe this horse hangs out in this corner because he knows that's where the stupid human is going to come from to let him out or to bring him a treat or to socially interact with him. Or maybe the mom or another horse that the horse is connected to is at this end of the barn. But there is definitely a draw to this corner. And so that's another reason that you don't want to be in this corner. Because now you're working against the horse's natural instinct to draw to all these other draws. You're in the corner. It's pulling the horse into you, and you're swinging a rope trying to keep the horse away from you so he doesn't trap you in a corner. Again, a lot of conflicting data. And I've watched 6 seconds of this video, and all of this has been playing in my mind. Okay, what's going on here? Why? So, again, I see things differently. Experienced horsemen see things differently than people who describe what's happening or who see things in the moment when they're doing it. If I'm in the moment and I'm seeing something, I will probably see it different if I videotaped it and watched it back. I always post videos and people, my viewers, will say, "Did you notice that? Did you notice that? Did you notice that?" And I didn't, because they see things differently and they're looking at it from a video and they can see the whole picture. So obviously when I'm watching a video, I can be more critical about things because I'm not focused on a horse. And if I'm focusing on a horse like I should be, then I should be missing other little things that I may not see. I'm not saying it's a good or bad thing. I'm just saying it is. All right, here we go. Filly's filling his oats. I don't know if this filly is kept in a stall. Why is this horse so hyper? Why is this horse running around? Why is this horse exhibiting so much energy that I have to run? In my mind, horse has been locked up. It's been caged. It's not out all the time. A horse that's out all the time doesn't do this. When I go out to my horses in pasture, they don't do this. And, you know, I always see people when, you know, new people will tell you, don't ever let your horse run away when you put it free in a pasture. And when you let it out, it'll turn around and make sure it faces you. And then after you take the halter off, make sure you shoe it so it doesn't come in on you and turn around because it'll kick you when it. And I hear all this bad advice. If you're letting your horse go and you're hitting it with a rope and shooing it off, you don't get it. And I see it at every barn, at every place I've been to. People who are scared of horses, who want to tell you they own 14 horses their whole life before they were born, they were training horses. Those are the people that don't have a clue. And, you know, am I saying this woman doesn't have a clue? I'm not saying she doesn't. I don't know what she... I'm looking at 10 seconds of a video, and this is what the questions that are running through my mind. this horse has an extreme amount of energy. Why? If you want to train a horse, this isn't the time to do it. This isn't the time to try and communicate. This isn't the time to try and teach the horse to listen to you. This horse is being a, you know, spastic kid that's been locked up all day and he just got off for recess and you gave him a candy bar. That's not the time to try and communicate and teach important lessons to a horse. Is she trying to do that? I don't know. I'm just telling you what I see. And a filly comes in again. There is a draw. Is the stupid human the draw? Is the corner the draw? Is there another horse close to the draw? Is there the food draw that the horse always gets treated? I don't know, but this horse wants to come in. Could the horse be coming in because it's lonely, because it's locked up, because it wants to socialize, because it wants to be a horse, and it's like, wow, I finally have a herd. There's somebody with me. I'm not alone. I'm not locked up. I'm so happy to be out here. I want to go play with my herd member. I want to be chased. I want to chase, because that's what horses do, is they chase each other, and they play with each other, and they push, and they draw, and this horse is being a horse, and a human is in the middle with a rope trying to film, shooing me away from all these draws. And is it right or wrong? Is the horse learning good or bad? Is the human causing all this? The human is absolutely causing or creating what's happening. So now it looks like the human is moving to the center, which I would have done pretty quick early, and I like being a center. Now once she gets to the center, again, I couldn't really tell from her email, and maybe you guys can read it better, but I just kind of scan things a little bit, and I miss a lot of message. It almost like she's telling me this is a video of her lunging the horse, and she wants me to critique it. She shouldn't be lunging the horse when it's in this excited, just newfound freedom of a horse. If you harass your horse when it's, especially a young horse, when it's experiencing freedom and it's running and it's excited and it wants to enjoy life, and then you want to come in and control everything. I want to teach you how to go left and right. I want to show you that I can control your feet. I want to lunge you and make you run around. I want to keep you out of my space so I don't get kicked. I want you to learn, but yet you're out there just being a young filly colt wanting to have fun. I mean, I see things from the horse perspective. When people start seeing things from the horse perspective, they change what they do. If you want change in your horse, you have to change. If you do the same thing all the time, you're going to get the same results. So when you get bad results and you do the same thing and then you blame the horse for giving you the same thing because he got the same thing, you're the one that's creating a problem. You're the one that needs a change. All right, let's go. I'm in a whole 21 seconds, and I'm in 13 minutes, and I haven't covered probably half of what's going on. But anyway, a little cute. Going back to that draw. Why is he going that corner? Got his head up, tail up, rearing. This horse is just so much saying, I'm free. I'm excited. I'm so happy to be out here. I'm not caged up. I have all this energy, and I get to stretch my legs, and I'm learning how to turn, and I'm learning how to prance and buck, and my tail's high, and I'm checking for predators, and I'm making sure I'm safe, and I'm making sure in case a predator's watching me that he sees that I'm strong, and I'm fast, and I'm agile, and I'm not an easy prey, so hopefully he won't attack me. And the horse is having all these emotions right now. And a human is, I got to film it, I'm lunging it, I'm making it stay out of my space, I'm making it run circles, I'm making it learn that I'm in control. I'm training my horse right now. Does anybody think anybody's training this horse? Or is this horse just being what a horse and just doing what horses do? I mean, I'm not saying this woman is bad. Don't come here and start hating and trying to make this into some hate video. I'm explaining on what I see when I see. Look at that little kick. Great little kick here. All right, let's go back here. Yeah. Okay. Was this horse mean right here? Was this a mean, I'm going to kick you because you're a stupid human and I'm going to show you I'm boss? Was this disrespectful? Was this horse not shown how to respect my space? Was this horse jumping in midair to try and intimidate me? And now I have to show it that you can't do that to me because I'm the higher horse. I'm the smart human. This horse was being a horse. This buddy does this to me probably 3 times a week. He'll fill his oats. He'll come running. I'm feeding him hay, and he wants to come in and just play and go, "Hey, Dad, yeehaw!" And he comes in, he bucks, and he turns his butt, and he kicks at me. If I wanted to start a fight and pick a fight and make this kicking an issue, I could show him who's boss. I could get my rope. I could get on my motorcycle and chase him till he's tired. I could tie him up to a post and make him tie till he learns the lesson. Because that's what the smart humans will tell you when they think they're better at being a horse than a horse is. Don't listen to these people. I got no problem with this horse did right here. Do I want to let him get close? No. Do I want to defend myself, keep him away from me? Yeah. To me, when Buddy jumps at me like that, I kind of get down and squat and kind of jump back at him, but I'm ready to keep my distance. I'm ready to stay away from the danger zone of the hoofs. A horse can't kick you unless you get close enough or you let him get close enough. Do I want to keep Buddy away and make him run away from me when he runs in and wants to play? No, I don't. Do you want to do this for a younger horse? I want to teach a little bit of boundaries to a younger horse. I don't want him to think he can come in. Because he'll come in and kick me thinking he's kicked his mom, he's kicked his playmates, he's kicked other horses. Because horses kick each other like humans bump into each other and push each other or punch each other in the arm. And it doesn't cause serious damage. Well, horses treat everything else like other horses, especially when they have a relationship and they're playing. So if this horse kicks you, it is not mean, aggressive, needs to be put down, dangerous. If you let your head get close enough to where you get kicked in the head and the horse gets put down because it's dangerous, I blame the stupid human. You didn't teach the horse to respect your boundaries. You weren't aware. You weren't agile enough to stay away. That's why I want open area. I said earlier, I want to be in the middle. When a horse comes in a box, I can read a horse when he's going to buck, when his body's turning, when he's haunching down. I read all that in very few split seconds, and I know how to keep away from that. I know how to keep just enough distance. I know how to be moving backwards when the horse is turning his butt to me, or move sideways, or move into him if I think I can avoid it that way. It's all a reading and communicating with a horse. If you aren't accomplished at that, if you haven't been kicked enough to learn those important lessons, if you haven't been around horses enough, then you got to get kicked a few times, and hopefully you don't get kicked in the head or in a heart or somewhere that's going to kill you, and you just get winged, and it's like, "Ooh, man, that was close. I need to learn. I need to be ready. I need to be stay away from that." I have no problem with this little horse kicking. I do have a problem if he kicks much close to me to where I can't keep him off. He spun in plenty of room to give her room and went away. Would he do that to his mom? Sure he would. Would he do it to his playmate? Yeah. He might even connect with a playmate, kick him in the rib. I can't count the number of times Mr. T has kicked Buddy. Buddy's kicked Mr. T a couple times, not a lot, but Mr. T has kicked Buddy. I can't even count the number of times, and I laugh every time it happens, and Buddy kind of goes, "Ow, that kind of hurt." But Buddy doesn't take it as Mr. T was trying to kill me. Mr. T was being disrespectful. Mr. T wasn't respecting my space. Therefore, Buddy's going to hate him and not feed him and put a blanket on him and lock him in a stall because he kicked him. That's what stupid humans do. Horses don't do that. Horses move on. It's not personal. It's what horses do, and you need to deal with it. And you're supposed to be the smarter animal, so you need to be ready to keep your distance, keep your horse away, be ready for it, know how to read a horse when he's going to do it, etc. All right. I love that little kick. Yeehaw! I'm a happy filly. Look at me. I'm strong. I can jump and kick. Yeehaw! What a cute little filly. All right. Is she lunging him? I don't know. Is the horse learning anything? The horse is running. What's he learning? Is there a draw to her? Yes, there's that draw. Why did he go to corner? Horses usually don't go to corners. Came back in, wants to draw. He's like, "Follow me. Let me out. I think there's a gate there." I you know what? By gosh, I think there is a freaking gate there. And I didn't see that before because I was watching the Philly. That's why he's going there. That's his escape. That's his back. If you keep a horse in a stall all the time and you only take him out to arena to make him run circles, he's going to learn that in a stall, I can stand around. Horses learn to find comfort and safety in a stall because they have to, because they learn that's the only place that I live that I get left alone. It's dark. They don't like it. People will say, my horse likes a stall. He doesn't go to a stall because he likes it, you big dummy. He goes there because he finds comfort and he's not getting pressure and nobody's riding him. Nobody's putting a bit in his mouth. Nobody's kicking him with spurs. Nobody's hitting him with a whip and making him run circles. He learns that the stall is my safe space. He does not like the stall. He doesn't appreciate the stall. He doesn't like standing in his urine and feces, dark, being locked up, not being anywhere. He wants to be able to run and play with other horses. That's what a horse likes. When you hear idiots tell you, my horse likes his stall, you need to have a big red flag that they don't have a freaking brain cell of understanding about what a horse is or what a horse is about. A horse is about freedom, running, exercise, playing, being with his herd now, being exposed to things that scare him, the wind, the rain, the elements, the mud, the chasing, the being fearful of predators and learning how to run and how to pick up danger and how to be alert and how to sleep only when a herd member is over him watching him and not to be out by himself sleeping or he becomes an attractor for a predator and an easy prey. I mean, how you look at a horse is real important. And unfortunately, the people educating people about horses, my horse likes a bit. He slobbers because a bit is good. Bits don't hurt a horse, it's the hands. If I have soft hands, a bit doesn't hurt a horse. My spurs, I just use them to guide the horse, to help aid in his communication. Yeah, I don't spur him to hurt him. I don't spur him to cause pain. No. It's to help in communication because I'm so good at being a great, smart human that I need sticky, pointy things to aid in my communication of my horse. I need a bit that causes pain in a horse's sensitive mouth because I'm so smart and good. When you start hearing all this ignorance, and I mean, it is rampant in the horse world, and you get a bunch of young people who don't know any better. You get a bunch of old people who rode a horse as a kid, and now they're getting back into horses, and they're overweight, out of balance. They're not proficient at anything with a horse, and so they're scared. And when they're scared, they'll listen to anybody to help ease their fear. So they'll become over-controlling, neurotic maniacs because they were told, that's the way you're safe. That's the way you have to be. Otherwise, you're not safe. And when you tell somebody that's scared and old, that's afraid to get hurt, how to be safe, they're going to listen to anything. They'll listen to any idiot and they'll pay them for the privilege of listening to an idiot because they're scared and they don't know any better. And they don't want to take the time it takes because it takes more time to do it right, but they'd rather do it again and again and then get hurt and blame the horse and come up with shortcuts and the easy pain bit and the easy stop bit and the easy gentle spur communication spur and the whip that doesn't hurt, it just helps aid. And it's just ridiculous on how people see horses and how somebody that understands a horse sees it so differently. Horse has a draw to the gate. That's why it keeps going back there. I didn't know there was a gate there. I was kind of wondering why the horse kept going there, but now I know. He wants to get to his other horses. He wants to get out of being chased if she's lunging him. If you create a work environment that every time the horse is in this area, he gets chased, harassed, ran, run around. If this horse was allowed to go out here and just play and poop and be himself for hours at a time, you wouldn't have this reaction. You wouldn't have this draw to running to the gate to get back to safety. He would learn to be comfortable. This horse doesn't feel real comfortable out here. But why is he not comfortable? Is he not comfortable because the stupid human is making him work? Is he not comfortable because he's not out here a lot? Is he not comfortable because he's alone and he's got friends in a barn that he would feel more comfortable? I don't know all these answers. These are just things that come to my head. This is how I see things when I look at horses. people will disagree. People will say it's me and I don't know what I'm talking about. Whatever. I'm not trying to show you I know what I'm talking about. I'm trying to educate you to open your mind so you see things without the blinders of the ignorance in the horse world. Because if you believe what you hear and you don't fact check it, you don't critical think it, you don't question things when it sounds stupid and unreasonable, you believe somebody when they go, putting a metal pain bit that gags my horse and hurts his tongue and tying reins to it and pulling on it is really good for the horse and the horse likes it. When you don't question that information, you're not critical thinking. You're taking the easy way. You're believing what you're told. You're doing what everybody else. You're going along to get along, and the horse suffers in the long run. Cute little video. I don't know how much I can help her because I don't see what she's doing. You know, I can't help you train a horse when I'm watching the horse and I don't see you. I have to see what the horse has done doing in response to what you are doing. Is the horse reacting or responding? Are you being clear? Are you being inconsistent? Are you being too aggressive? Are you scared of the horse? Are you backing away? Are you giving the horse a lot of miscommunication that the horse is confused? I can't tell all that when you're videotaping what the horse is doing. Now, somebody else may come here and tell you, you need to do this, and you should do this, and if you do this, the horse won't do that, and you shouldn't let a horse do that, and that horse shouldn't, and they'll have all this great advice. You know what? The people that have all the answers probably don't have the right answers. I see a horse over there, I think. So there's another horse over there. And again, I don't know if this is her facility. I don't know if this is a boarding facility. There's a lot I don't know, but I know this is a cute little horse. I absolutely see nothing wrong with nothing this horse did because it's never the horse's fault. And again, cute little video. I don't know if I helped her, but I probably helped a few other people understand a few things. All right, so we're going to go ahead and end that there, and hopefully you got something out of that. Again, a lot of times I create more questions than I clear up. People come to me with a question, and they want me to answer it and give them a clear-cut one answer. This is what you need to do. When people do that and give you that clear-cut answer, that's when you need to understand they don't get it. Because there's just too much information I don't know. There's too many factors and variables. There's no way that anyone can give you a clear-cut answer on something that has so many variables when they don't know from watching a 5 or 10 second clip. I can see what I think I see. I can tell you what it looks like to me from my experience. I can kind of read the horse a little bit because horses are usually consistent in what they're saying. But again, I don't know what outside factors are causing this horse to do what it does. I can't critique you because I didn't see you. I can't answer questions. That's why I don't answer questions. People try to email me. I mean, with a video, I have more information than a written email. And I still can't give you an answer. So when people email me with a question, I'm like, you don't get it. If you're writing me and expecting me to give you an answer from an email, you don't get it. And I'm not going to waste my time trying to get you to get it. I'll let you run around the internet and get other people to tell you, oh, yeah, I've got the answer to that. Buy my video. Buy this video. Buy my bit. Buy my special halter, reins, whatever. Then that's your answer. If you want to go to people like that for answers because you think it's easy and it's quick, that's why you don't get it. And that's why I can't help you. And that's why I'm not going to waste time trying to help you. I put out information. You can use it. You can expand. You can believe it. You can not believe it. You can hate on me and tell me I hate this poor horse because he's not wearing pink. And if he was wearing pink, then I would be picking on the mean color pink because I just hate women in pink. And shut up, you big dummies. His horses, ain't nothing wrong with his horse. Never's no horse. Never a bad horse born. They are made. Anytime somebody comes to me with my horse is stubborn, stupid, won't listen, doesn't respect my spit, I know automatically they don't have a damn clue on what they're talking about. All right, we'll end that there. What a great little filly.